If you want to be any good at security, you need to understand what you're up against.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
My dog along is not a very good guard dog, but you know, very cute.
Hey, do you want to come in? Welcome to the pack. Each card is a new question. Give us your best answer. Let's begin. I'm excited now. First card. What cyber attack has stuck in your mind? Oh, this is a good question. There's one North Korean group that did a really interesting double supply chain attack. They compromised a trading platform, pushed a malicious update to all of the companies that were using that trading platform. One of those companies was a teleconferencing app. So they did exactly the same thing again. So if you were using that teleconferencing app, you effectively were victim to a double supply chain. What are the top threats to cloud? When you look at the data, organizations are getting compromised because of misconfiguration, weak passwords, leak credentials. And that means that we're really empowered to actually improve cloud security. For me, that's actually a really optimistic story, as it's really easy to solve all of those problems. How has ransomware evolved in the last 5 years? It's a great question. I think ransomware is probably the top concern right now. In the past, ransomware was sent like spam, landing on devices and encrypting data on those devices. What we're seeing now is that they're gaining access to a device and they're moving through an organization's network, finding the most sensitive, the most critical part of that network. And it's only then that they're deploying ransomware. Can AI help keep us secure? Well, great question. And there's a lot of nonsense around AI. You've got to be really careful. For us at Google, we're focusing on some of the really basic problems, whether that's helping organizations understand threats or using AI to help reduce drudgery, huge opportunities with AI. You've got humans that might not be able to write, say, a technical detection rule, but they would be able to say, I want to know all the data that's been exfiltrated from my environment in the last week. And we can use AI to translate that into a technical detection rule. I'm excited. Cat or dog? Always dog. Beach or mountains? Mountains. Modern art or ancient history? Ancient history. I'm not one of those guys that always thinks about the Roman Empire, though. Latte or espresso? Definitely latte. Favorite crisp flavor? Well, that depends. Depends if it's a crisp sandwich or not. I'm a bit of a plain Jane, so let's call it ready salted. Have you ever seen a baby pigeon? No, and I don't know why not. Do the public need to worry about malware more? No, I think they've got better things to worry about. That's my job, that's Google's job. What's a zero-day attack? Oh, good question. So zero-day attack is when there's no patch available, so you're exploiting a vulnerability for the first time. Really difficult to detect. Can you tell us a recent trend? For me, big focus on supply chain compromise. Organizations have to think about not just their own network, but the suppliers they're working with and the data stored in those suppliers. Top threats to elections, for me, it would be hybrid operations, those that are blending network intrusions and information operations at the same time. You're setting up as UN Cyber Threat Council, who's on it? Great question. I think we need to make sure that the actual practitioners, those on the front lines, the incident responders, they have a big say in cyber policy.
All right.
There we go, like a pro. Okay. Roses are red, violets are blue. To protect your data, here's one thing to do. Let's go for multi-factor authentication. That's a really simple thing anyone can do, and it's going to have massive benefits for your security, give you real peace of mind. Some cybersecurity threats are sponsored by nation states. Can you tell us more? Really good question, and it's a tricky one. A lot of the most sophisticated operations are state-sponsored. North Korea might generate revenue for the regime. Russia might be very active in Ukraine. States use cyber operations in, you know, a variety of different ways, really linked to the broader objectives of the state. What's the best way organizations can stay up to date? Well, Google Threat Intelligence have a great blog, putting out really good stuff. Also conferences in Threat Intelligence, a load of really passionate people sharing their research. How have Chinese espionage operations evolved in recent years? It's a big question. So we've seen massive scope and scale of Chinese operations across a variety of regions and sectors. They're really active in targeting edge devices, also top the charts when it comes to zero-day exploits. So, you know, really a capable actor across a number of different strands. How can organizations keep clouds secure? The likes of Google Cloud or other cloud providers that are doing a lot of the heavy lifting there. It's about understanding what those secure by default settings, trying not to mess with them too much, and then keeping robust access control, managing identities well, all of those sorts of basics can go a really long way. How can organizations use cyber threat intelligence? You need to understand what you're up against. That's what threat intelligence is all about. It's about helping you understand what should you prioritize. The threats that are active in their sector or their region, we see so much noise, so many headlines about you should be worried about AI, you should be worried about Russia, ransomware. So actually having some data on the threats that really matter to organizations that look like you, that's gonna really go a long way in terms of making smarter decisions around security. And then the end. There we go. All done.
Congratulations. And you have won.
I got a pack of Ready Celtic crisps. Wow. Well, you know, real honour. I think I earned it. But yeah, it was a lot of fun. So thank you, guys. Nice job.